The rejection came at the end of the recent summit of the Bolivarian Alliance for the Peoples of Our America, or ALBA, in a final declaration read by Venezuelan leader Nicolas Maduro, in which the country strongly rejected the new sanctions announced against Venezuela and went further to demand the end of the U.S. economic blockade on Cuba. But Stephenson King says the region must be careful of condemning old friends.
If the prime minister and the other prime ministers of the other OECS countries, as you mentioned, condemn the U.S., then I believe there must be some genuine reason for that condemnation. However, we must understand as a country that we operate within a global environment, and we cannot continue to condemn our friends.
The ALBA countries also threw their support behind Argentina, which is not an ALBA member, in its efforts to end what some see as U.S. interference in Argentina's sovereign debt issues. But Stephenson King says given St. Lucia's already tense relations with the U.S. over alleged extrajudicial killings by local police, the island should be seeking to heal old wounds rather than create new ones.
We have been very cooperative over the years. For decades, we have been very cooperative to the United States. And we would imagine that notwithstanding the reasons for withdrawal of assistance to St. Lucia, that the United States must always consider us to be a strategic friend. We have been there, we have been supportive, we have been cooperative. And we believe that the best that the U.S. can do is to be supportive.
The U.S. cut off support to local law enforcement over allegations of extrajudicial killings by police and has refused to allow local officers to participate in any U.S.-funded law enforcement training activities. For the DBS News World, Kendal Burton reporting.